going to show you how to set up an MLA style Word document. By the end of this video, you will be able to have a document with everything in the right place, the right size, the right shape, that you can reuse for all your future assignments that require MLA format. MLA style requires size 12 Times New Roman, everything double spaced from where your name appears on that first page to the very last citation that you include, as well as a running head with your last name and page number, and 1-inch margins all the way around. So to start, you open up Word, of course. You have your option of templates, and we're actually going to just start with a blank document. So the first thing we can do is check for those margins, because that's the easiest. Modern versions of Word already default to 1-inch margins all the way around, but if you want to double check, you can look under Layout, Margins, and there they are, normal margins, 1-inch, everywhere already selected. Now, the next thing we want to do is add our font settings. So back under the Home tab, we could change Times New Roman and size 12 right here in this font cluster. But there's one extra thing that I want to do that will be very helpful for the future. I can click on the font settings arrow right there, or Control D is the keyboard shortcut. And you can see there's our Times New Roman size 12. But what we can do now is set as default. And when I click on this, I get the option to set my default for this document only, or for all future documents created from this basic normal blank template. I'm going to leave mine for this document only. However, I recommend that you select all documents for the future, because regardless of whether you're working out of MLA or using APA style for a psychology class or using Chicago style in a history class, chances are 99.9% of the assignments you ever turn in are going to use these basic size 12 Times New Roman double spacing guidelines. So either way, just make your selection and click OK. Very anticlimactic so far. The next thing we want to do is set our double spacing. This is another one where we could just set it from this Home tab, very conveniently right here in our paragraph settings. 2.0 is double spacing. However, we want to do one extra step with this, and you'll see why in just a moment. We have again paragraph settings, this little arrow to the bottom right corner. As we click on that, we can see we do have double line spacing selected, but the default for Word is to add an additional 8 points of space after a line, so that you can manually set what kind of spacing comes before or after. You can see the preview changing right there. And what we want to do to have a most correct template is to drop this down to 0. And you can see the preview in this box, how it cinches up just a little bit to see what kind of difference that makes. It may not seem like a lot, but it can be noticeable. If you want to set it as a default, it's the same thing as before, and we click OK, and it gets us back to our main page. Now, at this point, we're ready to actually start adding our content. MLA documents start with a 4-line header. MLA does not conventionally use any kind of title page, but as ever, always double check with your professor to see what they prefer. But in the traditional MLA paper, we start off with your name in the upper left corner. Hit enter. And on the next line, you're going to write your professor's name. And again, we hit enter. The next element is your course. And finally, we hit enter one last time and enter the date. And you can see Word is offering to pre-write it for me. All I have to do is click enter, so I'm going to do that. Now, that's our 4-line header. We want our title to come next. All we do at this point is hit enter once. We do not add any additional spacing. We will center right here in paragraph settings, or Control E is the keyboard shortcut to center justify this line. And the title of your assignment goes here. That may be dictated to you by the assignment guidelines, or you may have to create your own. It'll depend. That being done, We click enter one more time, go to another new line. Again, we don't insert any additional space. Back to left justify, and this is the point where we'd start writing the introduction to our paper. Now, the last thing we need to do to set up our document is to add our running head. So up here at the very top of the page, above where your name is written, you're going to double click in this space, and this will open the header and footer. Footer down there, header up here. Or you can go to insert, header, and we're going to go with this blank three column version. That will also open it as well. Once we start off, we're in the header and footer design tools, custom to this special part of the page. And you'll come over here to the left. The third option from the left is page number. And this is what you need to click on so that Word will automatically number all your pages for you and correctly update the page number so that page one is page one, page two is page two, and so forth. So we're going to click on that, choose top of page, and then plain number three. We don't want any additional bells or whistles, pretty colors or anything, just a plain number. And number three is the one that puts it over at the right corner of the page. So you just click on that. Our number one is inserted. And now all I have to do is type my last name in front of it and add a space. This part of your paper should also be size 12 times New Roman. If you set that to be the default for your document earlier on, you don't have to worry about reformatting it. Do double check though. If you didn't set it as a default, you're going to be seeing probably Calibri size 11 right now, and you do need to update that to be consistent with the rest of your document. To get out of the header, we can either click this red X, close header and footer, or just double click back in the body of your paper. The actual assignment is just going to be written out in all these pages. Your paper would, of course, go in the body of the document. I'm going to just use some placeholder text here for myself. Each new paragraph is indented like so, and all you have to do for that is hit the tab key once. You don't need to hit space multiple times. You don't need to hit tab key more than once. Tab once, inserts the line, everything else stays left justified until your next paragraph. As you go through and you're using information from other sources, you will of course need to include in-text citations. And that just looks like some parentheses before the end of the sentence. So we see before the period. And this is typically going to see a author's last name and possibly page number if applicable. If your source is a website or something similar, then you won't really have the page number. It's just going to be that author's name. And if there is no author, it's going to be whatever the start of that article title is, inside quotation marks, like so. Now, these in-text citations are just short little snippets that help connect your reader to your Works Cited page. Your Works Cited is on its own page at the end of your document. It stands alone. It should not overlap with any part of your paper. It is going to be titled Works Cited, and Works Cited will be centered. So again, we'll just click center and write in Works Cited, capital W, capital C. Enter, and then back to the left. Now, each of your citations at this point will follow MLA template for citation styles. The current version of MLA, MLA 8th edition, follows the same basic guidelines for every kind of source that you're going to be citing, which is true of pretty much every citation. Ultimately, you're trying to identify who wrote something, what did they call it, where did it appear in the world, and when was it created. So you typically have an author's last name, first name, title of the source, inside quotation marks, the website name perhaps, or the name of the newspaper or journal that it came from. Additional information, you might have the publisher of that website. Hopefully you have a date that it was last updated. And then finally, you have a location, which is typically going to be that website's address for that specific article. You can find more examples of how to actually write these citations for a variety of sources through our research guides that you can access at upresearch.lonestar.edu. Now I'm going to just insert some more gibberish text as an example, pretending that this is another source. Because one of the other things we want to do when we have a citation that runs across more than one line is we need to have this as a hanging indent to make it clearly readable. If it were like this, it starts running together looking like lots of paragraphs. So what we would do is highlight our citations after we finish adding them to this page. And once again, we're going to go back to that paragraph settings option. And now instead of spacing, we're going to be looking at this middle section, indentation. We need a special kind of indent, and that is the hanging indent. A first line indent is just like your regular body paragraphs, where the first line is indented half an inch. A hanging indent indents the second line, the third line, the fourth line, and so forth, while the first line stays all the way to the left. So we're going to choose hanging indent. 0.5 inches is the default spacing. That's just what we want. So we can hit OK. And now you can see with my two other dummy citations, the second line has been shoved over, and that makes it easier to read. Lastly, we want our citations to be in alphabetical order according to the first word. If you have just been typing your citations, letting Word handle the spacing so far for you, you'll be able to take advantage of the A to Z sort. Click right there. Paragraphs, ascending order. We don't have to change anything here. Click OK, and now everything is in alphabetical order according to the first word of each line. At this point, I'd hit save, my assignment's ready to turn in, and we're good to go. If you have any questions about how to do any of these steps, or if you would like someone to look over your assignment for formatting before you submit it, you're always welcome to contact the librarians by just walking up to the library. We're on the 8th floor of Building 12, or you can take advantage of the live chat, email, phone, or text message as ways to contact us. There's at least one librarian available anytime the library is open, and during the regular fall and spring semesters, we are open 7 days a week. Happy researching!